when she should have been raging from being sick and not wanting anyone to know because her pain might inconvenience them. She died of an overdose of people clinging to her when she didn't even have enough energy for herself. She died from loving men who didn't love themselves. They could only offer her a crippled measure of their affection. She died from raising children alone. She died from being sexually abused as a child and exchanging the humiliation for guilt again and again and again. The strong black woman is dead. The strong black woman is dead. She died from being dragged down and set upon by unevolved sisters posing as sisters and friends. She died from tolerating Mr. Pitiful just to have a man around the house. She died from sacrificing herself for everybody and everything when all she ever really wanted to do was be a singer, an actor, a dancer, or some magnificent other. She died from lines of omission because she didn't want to let the black man down. She died from being so responsible because no one else could be. The strong black woman is dead. The strong black woman is dead. She died from myths that would not allow her to show weakness without being chastised by the lazy, the crazy, and the hazy. She died from hiding her true feelings until they became hard and bitter, invading her womb and her breath like angry tumors. She died for never being enough of what black men wanted. The strong black woman is dead. The strong black woman is dead. She died from being too black and died again for not being black enough. She died from being misinformed about her mind, her body, and the extent of her royal capabilities. She died from knees pressed too close together because respect was never part of his sexual form. But sometimes when she just refused to give in, she was lynched and executed by the almighty image of blonde hair and blue eyes. Yeah. Or sometimes she was stomped to death in the form of high-tech ignorance just because you didn't meet her standard, my brother. The strong